Now ever the peacemaker, Mark Weston has his work cut out for him with the warring Jeffreys women in Shortland Street.
See? Now we're even. I embarrass myself, you embarrass yourself, cancel each other out.
A girl buys a bloke a pizza and suddenly they're an item?
When a girl looks at the bloke she just bought the pizza for, the way she just looked at you, then yeah.
Can a man and a woman not just be drinking buddies?
Of course they can.
Here's to that then.
To offer her some support.
And she'd turn on you because she's selfish.
Those hormone injections are really messing with her.
That is no excuse. She cannot talk to you like that when you are being the best sister in the world to her and you're letting her have some of your boyfriend's man juice.
Libby.
Man juice?
I'm not a fan of the S word.
Semen?
Ugh, that one too. I meant the other S word.
Sperm.
Oh.
Okay, can we stop talking about the man juice?
You're the one who brought it up.
I'm only saying, where is the gratitude from Maya? Where is the sisterly love? The things she said to us, they are unforgivable.
Severe mood swings, depression, emotional instability, it's all part and parcel of the hormone treatment she's on. She wouldn't have meant the things she said.
Mark's right. I mean, the things she said about him, of course she didn't mean it, because he...
She said things about me.
No one was safe from her poisonous tongue. And she called George something awful and homophobic, which makes her a hypocrite.
Maybe I should try and talk to her again.
You're the one who told me to steer clear. I should listen to you.
I'm gonna go call Mum.
To tell tales?
No, to let her know that she's not the only one that Maya has stabbed in the heart.
Oh, this is a disaster.
No, it's just another Jeffreys family fight. You have them every second week, don't you?
I mean the whole baby thing. Maya is alienating us all because of it. Maybe it was a big mistake getting involved.
Well, it's a bit late for that.
Is it?
If we change our mind now, it'll break Maya's heart. Look, I will talk to her, tell her nicely to pull her head in.
Good luck.
Honestly, everything's gonna be okay, Tance.
You guys are always fighting.
Not like this. This was bad.
How bad?
I told them all to go to hell, and I pretty much told Tanya that Mark was a man slut, and I called George a raving pillow biter.
Why?
And this was after I told my mum that she wasn't coming anywhere near our baby.
Ooh, well, there might not be a baby now you've abused the donor like
that. Don't say that!
I'm kidding. Tans knows that you're on these hormones. She knows that you didn't mean any of it.
They are giving us the most amazing gift in the world. Something we will never be able to repay, and I go and say something horrible.
See, maybe this is why it isn't such a good idea having your family involved in our sperm donation. Lady, you're always going to feel...
Jay, please, can we not talk about this? The thought that I might have ruined everything with my big mouth.
Hey. Everything's going to be okay, all right? I'll make sure of it.
Coming home soon?
Probably not. I have to clear the decks before this conference.
Was there something else?
I've been looking into recruitment possibilities to fix the nursing shortage.
Why? Libby already came up with a solution.
Last time I looked, I was nursing manager, not Libby. I've lined up interviews with graduate nurses through HR at Central. I should have several on the floor the week after next.
Meanwhile, orthopedic beds remain closed.
Not if I juggle the rosters, spread the shortfall through all the wards. Good night, then.
Night.
I'll give your son a kiss for you, shall I?
I'll see him tomorrow.
And then you take off for your conference.
For 2 days, Harry won't even notice.
You can keep your greasy meals and your fizzy concoctions and 8 glasses of water. Only way to cure a hangover really is a hair of the dog.
Spoken like a true alcoholic.
Mm-hmm. Nightcap?
I'd love one, but I'm not going to have one. Because one turns into two, turns into three, the next thing you know, you're pashing your boss and going to work hungover again.
Fair enough.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Hey, Alice.
Yeah?
You can stay here for as long as you want. I mean, if you can't find anything or anything like that.
Cheers, mate, but I'd better go back to TK's tomorrow.
Ah, can't handle a pastry Shay Valentine, eh?
You give me a run for my money, yes, but it's more to do with the fact that I pay rent at TK's. Plus, I don't want Sarah Potts getting the satisfaction of running me out of my own home. I was there first.
Yeah, she's a force to be reckoned with, though.
I'd take her any day.
Hey.
Hi.
How you doing?
I've been better, to be honest.
Yeah, I think Tanya's feeling a bit the same way.
Go on, you may as well get it over with. You don't want to be the donor anymore, do you?
Wow, must have been pretty full on, all the things you said about me to Tanya.
What, she hasn't told you?
Well, not word for word, no.
Mark, I didn't mean any of them. Lately, I don't know what I'm saying. I hear these words coming out of my mouth and I can't believe that I'm saying them. I'm an evil troll.
Interesting child we'll be having then. Part man, part troll. Maybe we could flog it off at the circus, make a bit of extra cash out of it. Of course, I'm still going to be your donor.
Thank you.
I understand the effects the hormones are having on you. Your sisters and your mother, however, aren't quite as understanding.
Right.
You need to sort things out.
I know. I don't know how.
Can you do an online grocery shop before you go? I always manage to miss something, and I do not need a Sophie-sized hissy fit while you are away.
Sure.
Make sure you get some beer. We will need beer.
You and the kids planning a wild party.
While you're slaving away, look, I know about these conferences. They give you half a day seminar, then they roll out the free booze.
If it were that much of a waste of time, I wouldn't be leaving you with the kids to go, would I? Justine Jones? Yes? Is there anyone else? I know it's short notice, but that shouldn't really be my problem. All right, thank you. Must be fate.
What?
The locum can't make it. I'm not going to the conference.
You have to go. What about our wild party? But seriously, just ring up the DHB and get another locum.
Too much hassle.
But this conference is an opportunity for you to make some great contacts.
You just said it was a booze fest.
Ah, the best business relationships are formed over a drink or three.
No, decision made. I'm staying home.
All right. All you have to do now is tell your travel buddy.
Chris won't mind.
Contact me via email rather than cell phone and only if it's urgent.
Gotcha. No disturbing unless absolutely necessary.
Thank you, Libby.
And I'll keep tabs on the nurses and let you know what's happening when you get back.
Actually, Tony will be deciding what happens there.
Huh. Okay.
Hi.
Hi. I can come back if you're...
No. Libby and I are done here. We've organised that girl. She's booked us each a cab for the morning. We have to be at the
airport. Actually, I can't go.
Pardon?
I want to, obviously, but the locum's fallen over, and you know as well as I do that we can't leave the surgical unit without a consultant,
so... Is that the best you can come up with?
Sorry?
If you don't want to spend time with me, just say. You don't have to go making up excuses.
It's the truth, Chris. I just got the phone call.
Yes, very convenient. How hard is it to find another locum?
It's a bit short notice.
Oh, cut the bull, Justine. Tell me what the real problem is. Please.